Hi guys, I've got something planned for this video. It's nothing big or too exciting, but I've got some cable that I have pinched from an old extension reel from the workshop. So I'm just going to get myself sorted. I only want the end, and I've got one UK plug and a double outlet designed for an extension cord. In fact, it used to be on one. Pardon me. Right, so what I'm going to do, I'm going to start with this end and hopefully may need to go find a Phillips. Yeah. I've got the toolbox right behind me. Really? My cable's doing a runner. A couple of different size crossheads hit. Here we go. I know the angle's not very good, but not a lot of room. I can't take the camera back any further. It's zoomed out as far as it will go. So I've got four screws in the back of this. This has had a lot of use, and I've had this for quite a number of years. Right, here we go. See, it's got all the compulsory shutters. Although I have noticed this one's broken. Ooh, oh dear. And that is actually on the live side as well. Oh dear. Still works though. Oh well, theoretically I shouldn't use it because it's broken, but it's only me. The worst I can do is blow myself up with it. Or shock myself. But I'm old enough to know better than sticking things in there, so, and I don't have any little kids around, so it'll be fine. I wouldn't recommend using it if you had kids around, though. I suppose if I could find another similar socket to this, I could actually replace that. In fact, I know I could. Right. In theory. Get out of there. Yeah. I knew one would do it. Get out of there, you son of a bitch. There we go. Bugger off. There we go. So it's live, earth, neutral. Ah. So this might catch some people out, because this isn't labeled or marked with an L. This is marked with a C for common. Ooh, so if you're not careful, things like that might catch you out. These contacts are a bit dirty, but still, they're okay. Right. So, the next thing I need to do is strip some of this back now. I'm going to use one of these. Got to be careful doing this, because the number of times I've used a knife and gone too deep, I don't particularly want to go too deep. So I'm just going to score all the way around, minding my fingers, because I don't want to take my fingers out either. Did I? Ah, good. No, I didn't. I didn't catch him. Sorry. Knocking into the camera with the cable, because it's hanging off the edge of the bench, so it keeps dragging. Right, so what I'm going to do, probably going to sit this in here and get the cord grip, screwed back into place. Yep. Like so. Now I can sort these three cables out, or wires out, I should say. Okay, I've already got one stuck. Ah, may just loosen that off and just rotate the cable round so the neutral is over here. And I'll just, make life a smidge easier. And things a little bit tidier, so if I do this, just rotate the wire. Like so. I'm just gonna screw the screws back down. That's better. Right. So it's just basically just like that. Neutral over to the right, brown to the left, earth straight up and in the middle. Now, do these come out? If they come out, that's going to make life a heck of a lot easier. But I can't remember because it's been a while. Ah, yes. Well, actually, if I could just lift it like that, that will make life easier. And we'll give that a snip. I hope I haven't just done that far too short. These are, you know, I don't think I've ever used a proper pair of, wire strippers. I've always used the side cutters, or the cutters, whatever you want to call them. Right. Push our wire in. Undo up the screw. Hang on. Go. We push our contact back into place. Push our live wire down. Good. Not good. Gone in twisted. There we go. We're in. I'm just going to do the same with the blue. I have got proper wire strippers. I don't know if I actually put them in this toolbox behind me. If you just squirt around like that and pull, this wire is pretty tough. In case you were wondering. Right. I'm now going to try and get back on camera. Just raise that enough to put the blue wire in. Push it in. Tighten the screw. Get the blue wire pushed into place. We hopes. Crap, I think I might have just done that a bit too short. Then I just actually, I know what I could do. I know what I can do. I don't really want to do it, but that might help. Come on, you son of a bitch. One wire left, and that's the earth. And I've got to do the plug. So, there we go. That's just that one, which is simple. Just goes straight up. Does the earth come out of that one, or is that going to be extremely fiddly because the neutral is in the way? Can I pop that out of there? I tell you, it's going to be a heck of a lot easier if I can raise it a little. I don't think I can. Oh, hang on. Might be able to. It moves, but it's as much as it does. If not, I'll just have to take this off and pull the wire back and get the earth on there and piss around that way. Just been around to strip this wire back. Oh, bloody hell, this wire's tough. It really is. Yeah. What I'm gonna have to do is take the cord grip off once again. Like so. Take it off completely. And I'm gonna try and get me earth in this here. Yeah, I got it in. Okay. Screw down the terminal screw. In the cord grip. We can put the front cover, the top cover back on. Round the right way would help. We put the screws back together, and this end is done. One. Thought I had another one of these, to be honest. But I haven't. Right. So, according to the timer on the camera, it's taken us nearly 13 minutes to do that one. It shouldn't take us as long to do the plug. Just got to get the other end of the cable. Here we go. Right, now, I believe this is fitted with a 3-amp fuse, which isn't any good, as it needs to be a 13. This plug is relatively new. I'm not sure. It looks like a set of Christmas lights was on it, but yep, it's got 3-amp fitted. I'm hoping this one's going to have a 13 in. If not, I've got a tray of fuses, so it's not an issue. Right, I'm going to undo the cord grip. I'm going to take the cord grip off of this one. I'm just going to undo the screws. Funny looking screws where you can use either a flathead or a Phillips, but nearly every time I can guarantee a Phillips will grip that. If you look at the heads on the screws, just about make out the slot for a flat head, but you can also use a cross head. Right, let's take this wire out of there. Fuse holder, like so. I'm going to do the same again with this end of the wire. Just gently score around with the knife and then bend the insulation, and it should, as it has. I'm getting good at doing that with a knife. That's not a knife. This is a knife. Okay. Yeah, I know the wires are yards too long, but I'll deal with that in a minute. get all the wires in. Come on.
Right.
Need to back these screws off in the cord grip a bit more. Like so. Stop going up there, you bastard. Let's see if you can go anywhere, go around there. Hang on a second, I'm gonna have to just go behind the scenes, as it were, and get this poxy brown wire in there. There we go. Right. Get the black flex up there. Let's just get that screwed down. It's quite a thick old cable, this one. Came from an old heavy duty extension reel. Right. So those two have got to go around that way. Because obviously, your ground, or your earth, I should say, goes to the top. The longest pin. Can't really go wrong because they are marked. Blue goes here, bottom left. Beginning to wonder why I chose this plug, because there isn't a lot of room to move at all. Yunk. Rotate my cable a bit. Might make life a little easier when positioning the wires. Right, so got them two done. Done and cut and whatnot, so I'm putting that in first. Then the blue, it's not very flexible, this flex either, for some reason. Where's my... this in and just measure up. Just a rough guess. Somewhere there should do it. So that's the wires cut to length. So now I've just got to strip the ends off. I usually use my teeth, but I don't think I fancy doing that on this. Square it around. So, that's the live done. Do the other two. One more. I'm actually gonna just trim a little extra off of that. Together. Forgot to mention that when I did the socket end. Right. Naturally, the earth screw on the earth terminal screwed all the way in because it wasn't used on the fairy lights that were connected to this. Doesn't really matter what wire you start with. I just start with the earth for some reason. Right. Now we get the blue. I don't know why, but Nemo's meowing his head off for some reason. Just get that pushed in there. Get me screw. Thank you. they were washed in properly. The one not being caught in the cover, so just give that a push in. Right, last wire, the brown, which is the live. I think in the US you'd call it the hot wire. Ouch. We just call it the live. Right. We stick the live in like that. Precious kidding me. Fucking wall's too big. Won't go in the okay. A problem there. There we go. Gone in. We'll go in with a bit of brute force. My neutral wire's popped out of the terminal. That is not good. That means the screw didn't bite on the wire for some reason. Why didn't that bite down on the wire? It was in there. It's all mushed up. Should we try that once more? Oops, sorry. My thumb caught the camera. Right. I felt like that caught the wire that time. Just try and press that down. Yep, we're good. So now I'm just going to hope I've got 13 in here. Otherwise I've got to go to my fuse tray. No, that's typical, it's got 3 in it as well. Should have known from the size of the wire in here, actually. Right. Just give me 2 seconds and I'll just run and grab a fuse. 2 seconds, whoops. Preferably without losing the lead. Easier to come back with the tray. Right. In here, let's rotate the camera. There's all my fuses. And all I want is one of them. That goes in there. So your live comes in through the fuse down the wall. This on, and we're done. Just make sure the cord grip is screwed down nice and tight. I don't think that's going to go anywhere. Now the other thing I'm going to do, that's got fitted, I'm off camera, hang on, turn the camera. That says fitted with 3 amp fuse. Well, no it isn't, so I'm going to peel that off, so just in case I loan it to anyone, they're not going to get confused and think they've got to put a 3 amp fuse in there in case it blows. Because you never know. There we go. Oh, it's a void sticker. Oh well. It's not on the set of lights. This was that came with this plug anyway, or this plug came with, so here we go. That's it. So in 20 minutes, nearly 25 minutes actually, you can make your own extension lead. I've got one here which is plenty long enough now for what I want. Next one I'll do is one of these. Just a standard one. I haven't got the lead out of the cupboard yet, so or cable, I should say. Correct term, cable. So, I won't be doing that tonight. Anyway, thanks for watching. I hope you found this little video useful. Just put the blade in on my knife so I don't catch myself on it. If you did, hit the like button. And don't forget to subscribe for more daily videos. I will try to do some more videos like this, you know, some how-to sort of videos, more than the vlog, so stay tuned, and I'll talk to you again soon. Bye.